The sell-out concert was organised by the local singing group Miscellany to celebrate their 30th anniversary and to raise funds to refurbish the community centre buildings. 144 performers were taking part, representing no less than 8 choirs from the town. The evening was introduced by Joe Norman.
It has been known for a very long time that singing is good for the soul and also good for your health. As William Byrd said in 1588, it doth strengthen all parts of the breast and doth open the pipes. Still true today. More recently, studies have shown that singing delays the onset of Alzheimer's. So without making any aspersions on the people here, if you're not already an active singer, why don't you join one of these fine singing groups?
Thank you.
Bravo 8, Charlie Sierra, took control of Ken Village Hall a few weekends back when the 2nd Clevedon Scout Group set up an amateur radio station with that call sign and took part in the International Jamboree of the Air.
He's a Russian or Eastern European.
During the weekend, contacts were made with other radio stations throughout the world, including the Falkland Islands and the British Antarctic Survey ship RRS James Clark Ross, as it ploughed its way south through the Atlantic Ocean.
Call sign is Golf Bravo 8, Charlie Sierra. Golf
this contact Bravo was nearer eight, home Sierra. In northern France.
QSL Foxtrot's by Italy Yankee uniform stroke portable. This is Golf Bravo 8, Charlie Sierra. Good afternoon to you. The name of this end is Dave, Delta Alpha Victor Echo. The location here is Clevedon, Charlie Lima Echo Victor Echo Delta Oscar November Clevedon in North Somerset. We are a special event station for the scouts for their Jamboree of the Air.
Many of the contacts were with other scout groups taking part in the Jamboree. Here, Taylor talks to a fellow scout located somewhere near Manchester.
Golf Bravo 2, Papa Papa Sierra, Golf Bravo 8, Charlie Sierra. Yeah, Roger, his name is Taylor, Tango Alpha Yankee Lima Oscar Romeo. I'll let him tell you, give you the QTH, then we'll clear from you. Thank you.
Okay, thanks for that, David.
Okay,
Cleveland, tell us where you are, that would be great.
Cleveland.
Spell it with. Charlie.
Lima. Echo. Victor. Echo. Delta.
Oscar.
November.
You get that over.
In true scouting fashion, of course, the weekend at Ken was spent under canvas in a small orchard next door to the hall. There was a serious side to the event, as many of the scouts were working towards their communications badge, which requires them to log 25 amateur radio stations, explain how radio waves travel around the world, and to know and use the phonetic alphabet. But even speaking to fellow scouts in the Hampshire town of Bishop's Waltham was not easy.
We're running the station for the second Clevedon Scouts, and we're just outside Clevedon in North Somerset. A little village called Ken, which is called Kilo Echo November November. We've been on the air for, this is our second day now, so we've done quite well. I have one young lady who's doing a communications badge today, Georgina, who I'll put on the microphone in a minute, and also if any of your scouts wish to reciprocate with greetings messages, more than welcome to accept them. There you go. Hello, my name is Georgina.
Hello, my name is Georgina, and I'm in the second Cleveland Scouts.
Over.
Over.
I think it's an airline, and I think it's obviously a French.
It's about their W Pacific air traffic.
Yeah, it could be. They may be a little bit out of date, but I think that's what we're listening to.
Yeah.
And you're listening to an aeroplane talking back to its base, but it's French.
Maybe he's getting landing information, you know, they're going to land, because that's what my tutor said.
Throughout the weekend, the many contacts made by the budding radio operators were logged on a computer map, including this opportunity to speak to Marco in northern Italy.
Hello Marco, my name is Taylor and I am a scout. I am working towards my communicator badge.
Over.
Hello.
Your name, Taylor.
My name is Taylor.
Tango.
Tango, Alpha, Yankee, Lima, Oscar, Romeo. Over.
Over 60 competitors turned up to register for this event, which took place in the leisure centre's swimming pool and then out in the adjoining sports field. Regular viewers of Clevedon News will remember our featured item, the aquathlon, held last July in the Marine Lake. Well, this is an indoor version where a number of lengths of the pool are swam and then several circuits of the field were undertaken outside. The pool at the Strode Leisure Centre is home to the members of the Clevedon Amateur Swimming Club. But several of these splash and dash competitors have travelled up from Burnham and Weston to be here today. First into the pool were the 8 and under group. They were required to swim just 2 lengths of the 25 metre pool and then to run once around the field outside. As the following groups got older and therefore more experienced, the distances both swimming and running increased. Into these races were several team races where the swimmer would hand over to the runner outside. These teams were timed and judged separately and received separate awards.
Thomas, good lad. Come on. Good lad. Come on, Thomas. A sunny day greeted the competitors on the outside.
Yes, Callum, keep going, push it!
But the temperature changed from the warmth of the water in the pool to the cold October day outside must have raised a few goose pimples. Soon to be dismissed by an energetic jog around the sports field.
Go on, Mez.
You don't need to know them. telling you later about that from here next week. Olivia Finney from Cleveland Swimming Club did the swim. Dad accompanying. Isn't it wonderful how the dads just do the last 50 metres? Well done, Lizzie. Nice strong finish. Excellent. Well done.
The many prizes were presented by Graham Feeble, a Clevedonian who had officiated at the modern pentathlon during the recent London 2012 Olympics.
Well done, Bethan. Looks like Bethan's a swimmer with Western Supermare, so well done. Is it another Western swimmer? Rachel Anderson! Well done. Western Supermare females, Kirsty Jenkins. I wasn't too small for Burnham, by the looks of it. Well done, girls. Nathan Turner. Nathan, and Matthew Keehan. Well done, Matthew. Lucy Davies. Well done, Lucy. From Cleveland Swimming Club. Well done, Lucy. From Cleveland Swimming Club, Karen Greenwood. Harry Elmer. Is Harry here? Yes, well done, Harry. Come on, Claire. Our gold medalist as well. Excellent. Well done, Kerry. Thank you. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for coming and supporting the event today. We hope you've enjoyed it. People look out for the aqua farm and the long swim. And don't forget to look at clevedonnews.org.uk to see yourself on film. Thank you very much. Have a safe journey home.
The object of this exercise was to give members of the 1st Cleveland Scouts some idea of what it is like to sleep rough, out in the open without a roof over your head on a chilly October night.
Right, now, can I please have a layer of cardboard? board on top of here?
Yes, Taylor.
Thank you.
There were 14 hardy young volunteers and, to keep order, they were joined by five of the group's leaders who spent the night in the open with them. Three in the relative luxury of their tents and two roughing it with the scouts themselves.
So we need to put boxes together and think about really how you're going to get into them.
Get them taped together. Get them taped together.
Where's the tape?
Here.
The cardboard boxes and pallets were kindly donated by Six Ways Sports and Hobdens, the local furniture removal people.
So we'll get chilly though overnight and into tomorrow and Sunday. It's cold all weekend. What's going to happen is that Arctic blast will come down, clearing all the cloud out of the way tonight, the remaining cloud, and then giving us clear skies into Saturday. And then clear skies combined with that cold air mean temperatures really plummet tonight. We're looking at a widespread frost right across the board, and in some of the more rural spots, temperatures certainly going sub-zero. Oh, so tomorrow morning, it's a very, very different picture, David.
You're desperate. Oh, no!
Yeah, it's a bit
of
a storm.
Everything went good, apart from mine and Vox's box sort of demolishing us.
When was that? In the middle of the night?
Yeah. And
now people are trampling as we speak.
Yeah.
There you go. Two bits of bacon.
Jets, go away.
It's the fat on it.
Yeah, we'll chew the fat as well.
It's good for you.
Yeah,
it keeps you warm.
Really good, actually. It's really warm and very well insulated.
That's enough to do your sleep now.
Yeah. Apart from we had to go around a lot to get into the right place.
And how long do you
just keep it moist. You're fine. Two bits of bacon, all right, and
sure. Probably about 5 hours.
I got on fine except for massive, that my hands got really cold and I nearly ended up.
And how long do you reckon you slept?
I slept for about 7 hours and a half.
Yeah,
the Royal British Legion's annual poppy appeal always starts with a local meeting of the 30 or so volunteer collectors. For the last 11 years, they have been organised in Clevedon by Chris Norrish. But this year he has hung up his collecting tin and retired from active service, so to speak. The Legion's community fundraiser for Somerset, Sue Potipa, was there to thank him. The next job for the new coordinator, Neil Isaac, and his team was to collect the poppies from the storage depot. More than 40 million remembrance poppies are made at the Legion's poppy factory each year. The money raised during the appeal goes to support the Legion's welfare work for the armed forces community.
Right,
A room at the Ken Road Methodist Church serves as a storage place for the poppies, and this is where the volunteers come to collect their boxes, trays, and of course, their poppies.
10 years since I've been here. Nobody ever walking backwards and forwards.
See you.
The appeal is the Legion's biggest fundraising campaign. Lapel poppies are available to buy in shops, supermarkets and pubs from now until Remembrance Sunday on the 11th of November.
But the one for, yeah, all of those on that.
Yeah, all of these up here.
Is there an extra one for the wood?
In 2011, the Clevedon branch of the Royal British Legion raised over £20,000 for the appeal, a total they are determined to improve on this year.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Last year's national total was £42 million.